I swear a little bit in this video, so MA15 plus.
toothbrush.
If it's an individual or a business or an industry, you'd think yourself that
wash,
you
wash, wash.
Out early.
Yeah, right.
Please don't. Please keep yourself safe, keep your household safe, keep your workforce safe,
yeah,
your customers and all
that. That's bullshit as well.
We do need everyone to play their part.
Everyone's got to stay at home still, stay at home still, stay at home still. Yeah, right. It is safe.
The pathway intentionally takes a
granted at the moment.
With lifting restrictions,
yeah,
that will be based on
maybe dodgy.
Of the lifting and
but
the
as soon as they've had no cases for 2 weeks, guaranteed we can get out a lot more. As for this social distancing bullcrap,
so
that's
please
fine.
Be patient, be cautious, stick with
come
plans
on,
and help keep
how weird
safe over the coming.
They want to keep going on and on and on. Oh, quick, quick, quick. This is a killer virus. Quick, quick, quick. Then do your fucking jobs and get some fucking blood plasma together. And then when people get sick, chuck fucking blood plasma in them. That way they never get to the point where they get really sick. And their body may fight it off a lot easier as well.
Oh, yes, it is. It's
dangerous. In a population like Tasmania now, you do the blood plasma antibody thing, you've got no fucking problem. We've got that many, well, that few people.
They're not considered a new case.
Now,
we return that person to isolation and we manage them very cautiously to protect public health.
But now you can just,
Premier's press conference there this morning as it goes
well,
to
you
the
can
questions.
Just have that,
once again, it returns on Thursday morning now.
Plasma thing and give it to people who are infected. It's quite fucking easy.
Change to that and then Sunday, so we'll review the press conference
and the
on Monday morning.
That, the,
but if you've got any
the
comments
more
out of anything that was discussed this morning, 1300.
You're not going to get more and more and more cases? But we've already got a bit, there's nothing
the
at the goes. Moment. So that's good.
John Legend and Chrissy Teigen, New York City home, and it does not look like it's been lived in by a human. I'd hate to live like that. I mean, I'd love to live in New York in a fantastic apartment, but I'd also like to live in New York in a fantastic apartment. You don't have an apartment that you're just sort of too scared to sit on it.
Yeah, I've never continually washed my face and hands and all that crap. There's no real point.
The actions of Tasmanians are making a difference in the fight against COVID-19,
more,
but we must remain
more
vigilant.
That you need to wash
stay
your
home
face
unless you must
hands.
Go out. If you're out,
your
stay 1.5 metres away
if you
from
keep,
others.
Not
practice good hygiene,
wash
your
hand
hands
all that
thoroughly
crap.
And regularly.
Well,
download the Australian Government's COVID Safe app. If you have any COVID symptoms, please.
Tickle down the nose there. I only do washing of my hands like normal, and sure, I haven't got the coronavirus because there's no coronavirus around, but I also have only had, 8 colds in my life, 40? Colds, flus, whatever you want to call it. The only time I really had a bad one was when I had my, I was in school, primary school, so it must have been when I was, before I hit my teens, and that one knocked me for a 6, had a good, they said, oh, you got a fever, blah, blah, blah. I was like, do I have a fever? I don't know, Mum. She didn't have a thermometer or anything. But I was pretty much warm, and I was on the couch, it was my fucking birthday. And I was like, and all that. But ever since then, I haven't had a real bad cold. I've only ever had cold and flu that's lasted anywhere between 1 day to 3 days. Had one that lasted 5 days. Just wanted to sit there in the background where you just had a little bit of a sneeze, a little bit of a sniffle, but not a lot. I just sat there and sat there and sat there. So there you go. For influenza and colds, I'm pretty good. I don't know about the COVID virus, though. I'd love to figure that out, but unfortunately I've got a elderly mother at home and I don't want to infect her with COVID. Just wait until the vaccine comes out. The elderly will be the first people to take it, of course, so that'll be mum. And then it'll go down and filter down to other people. But it's totally useless, I think, unless you've got a body so that you know the vaccine works.
What have we got here anyway? Is that fella going up there to help, is he? Oh, he is. Next thing you know, it'll be happy doctors there.
Or you can send it via our website and I'll read it.
Or it'll be happy scientists there.
1-300-00-1012. 25.
I know these days have been pre-approved agents and agents there, but come on.
Is Tasmania Talk on 7XS. Hi, it's Alex Jackson, News Director at 7XS. Information on the coronavirus crisis is changing by the hour. Our commitment is to bring you everything you need to know from around the world and how it's affecting our great state. John Fabris.
40 northern doctors are calling for tougher
measures. Olivia Hicks.
Tasmania's wholesale fuel price is still reaching a
record. Grady. Tasmania is moving to stage 2. And myself. It's free news made in Tasmania 7 days a week. You can catch up with the latest right now at 7xs.com.au.
Tasmanian bus drivers are at the ready to help you reach essential services. If you're feeling sick, don't catch the bus. You should only be catching the bus for essential travel. You have a responsibility to keep yourself, your bus driver, and other passengers safe. So, if you're feeling sick, don't catch the bus. Stay home, save lives. Visit coronavirus.tas.gov.au.
The Railway Hotel is
Damn it.
Not gonna say it.
I'll say it. People need to learn how to drive. Me, I was, well, close enough to on the wrong side of the road myself, but still. Can't drive with a freaking trailer, don't freaking drive at all. Blah, 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 and all that stuff. See, I'm going over the wrong side of the road occasionally because I'm opening up a sandwich cheater. But also, in saying that I'm going slow enough so that I can get back on the right side of the road and that.
Hang on.
Oh, get over the right side, or left side of the road, come on. During COVID, the NBN code allows 40% extra bandwidth to be ordered by companies for no extra cost. So, during the NBN, I mean during the COVID, NBN's going to go nice and fast for everyone. Until they say, oh, COVID's basically ended now. Oh, fuck you, you don't need the fast speed anymore. And instead of providing people with a good speed, I can get near 3 megabytes a second in at night, or around 3 or 4 in the morning. It's quite good. It maxes out my thing and uploads, what is it, 300 to, 200 to 300 kilobytes upward. Everything I used to do anyway. Go to the tip. Get food. Go get mail.
It really helps us in the
and as for, oh, don't go into the store for anything you don't need essential. You don't see the shopkeepers going, well, why are you in here for? That went down the wrong hole. The reason why they don't do that is because they're making money. But you see a lot of people in town that just fucking rush past you, they don't give a shit about social distancing. They're like, oh, we're not gonna get caught. No way I can get the virus. Not around here. We've got it down, blah, 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 blah. I guarantee you that's going through people's heads. Anyway, let's hear what the other people have to say.
Hey, do you miss your library?
Oh, yeah, library.
A press conference with the Premier, but it hasn't been mentioned on there. Would you be able to find out somehow and let people know in Alveston when the library and the council chamber
I can tell you right now, Margaret. So community and local government facilities and libraries are allowed to open for up to 10 people from next Monday. So that's the next the first phase.
Monday on the 18th.
So the 18th. So that's the very first step of the recovery. I think I was reading that those restrictions on the 10 people will be eased in stage 3. Possibly, but don't hold me to that, but definitely from next Monday, the very first step will be community and local government. We've had a lot of people call about libraries, Margaret.
Well, you see, the older generation, we still read a lot.
Yes.
And we do miss books that we want to take out.
Absolutely.
I suppose all of us have got a small library of ourselves, but it's nice to get books from the library and speak to the people there, because they're always so obliging and lovely to deal with.
Libraries. Margaret, we'll talk about some of these organisations going forward as they start to open again, but thanks for your call.
Thank you, Aaron, and I'm glad that you pointed that out to me. I shall put that on my calendar, 18th of this month, library.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
All the very best to you. Bye.
You too, Margaret. Great to talk to you. So community and local government facilities and libraries are allowed to open. That's an important part of that, right? Allowed to open for up to 10 people from next Monday, May 18th, as part of step one of the roadmap to recovery. So once again, I think it's important to talk about some of these organisations as they open. So we'll check in with a couple of councils next Monday as those restrictions start to ease. 17 to 12.
Tasmania Talks Sports.
Brent Costello, with New Sports Reporter. Hello.
Hey Aaron, how are you?
I'm well. Did we start to get a better idea of what's coming in the AFL yesterday?
A little bit, I guess. The same as June 11 mark is looking like the date we could potentially return, but there's still a lot of dominoes that need to fall, I guess, and the training is a big one, and how that's all going to work. Obviously, Daniel Andrews came out yesterday and said Victorian clubs will be right to train from tonight, but the AFL needs to get a system across the country in place, I guess, so it is an even playing field for all the teams. So we wait for that to happen, and we'll be a little bit closer. But the date, sort of looking around that June 11 mark, which is what, less than a month now, that was the 11th yesterday, wasn't it? So,
yeah, absolutely.
Pretty exciting.
So what does this mean for the Crows?
Yeah, well, they're like the first things we're handed down this, or the results of their investigation of Sama had all those 16 players that were involved in that to have one game suspended each, and that's a bit of a wet letter sweep, I suppose, in the AFL, really, because suspended sentences, well, how often do you see those sort of triggered, I guess? So they've really got off a little bit scot-free. Ben Hart, and a couple of coaches have taken the hit for the club, and he's been suspended for just over a month, I believe, and won't be available to work back at the club for another 6 weeks or so. So that's where all that lies. So we can move on from that now. It's all been handed down, but everyone still wanted to talk about it, just whether it was a harsh enough penalty.
So you don't think so?
Probably not, no. I think a fine would have been a little bit tough, given the current situation that clubs are in financially. Some people even suggested potentially losing premiership points. It's a tough one, I guess. The general opinion yesterday when they were handed down was it wasn't tough enough.
Well, I mean, once again, I mean, we keep saying it, I wish I had a dollar for every time I heard the word, but unprecedented times. I mean, what do you compare it to?
Yeah, that's exactly right. It's a unique situation that these guys, some said these guys should have been all put in the same place together. They would have been better off being quarantined in their own home, once returning to South Australia, rather than going to Barossa Valley all in one group together. So you're right, though. It's hard to compare it. It's hard to know what the right thing is to do in this situation. None of us have been before, so we've got to take this some way.
We had the Premier Peter Guthman's press conference at 11 o'clock. He mentioned racing again. He actually referred to the fact that it was like looking over the back fence, and you can see racing happening in other states, but not happening here. But we've got a better idea now of the road forward.
Yeah, obviously we've got that date in the middle of next month, the race can resume, but a lot of people said I'm flying in, and that's still too far away. The other question that was posed was, have our sports been very strong? We need to have very strong to lead up to these races. And the answer on Friday is no. But the Premier said in the conference this morning that there will be discussions had today, and hopefully that the barrier trials can take place before racing does start, because that will just delay when racing could return even further. Because if they had to wait for June 13 to barrier trial their horses, that could race meeting probably start for a little while after that. So that's where that currently sits at the moment. So hopefully we'll have a better idea on that late today or early tomorrow.
Brent, you know you're racing. Is it possible to put a percentage or a number on the people from the Tasmanian industry who are over on the mainland right now?
Yeah, not entirely sure of an exact figure, but we just have to look at our star jockey Craig Hewitt leaving. As I said to you last week, Siggy Carr, one of our trainers, she had to send half of her horses back to the mainland. So I don't think too many industry participants have actually made the move. Craig Hewitt, as I said, one of them. But someone like Scott Brunt, for example, probably our most prominent trainer here, along with Adam Trinder on the northwest coast. Scotty Brunt had to make the decision to stay. They can't really go anywhere. The train is ticketed because of all their losses here. So they've got property here, etc. So that's hard for them. So if anyone's going to go up to the jockeys and the horses, and we've seen, as I said, Craig Hewitt and a number of horses leave. But as far as trainers go, I think the majority have stayed here.
Because if they're going to come back for the resumption of racing mid next month, then they would have to come back soon. They'd have to go through the isolation process.
Correct, exactly right. So they've got to take that all into account. That's going to be an interesting thing. Craig Newitt decided to come back.
This isolation thing would be a lot easier if they had tests that were
a wonderful career on the mainland. I think 30 odd Group 1 winners over time. But
where have I heard that there's a test that could be done in 5 to 15 minutes?
So
why the fuck don't they buy one or two of them machines?
A lot of people are asking about junior sports. When can we expect junior sports to be back on the field?
Yeah, look, it's a bit of a waiting game. Still, contact sports is a bit of a different ball game to a game of tennis or things like that. So we'll have to wait and see where the guidelines come out around that. But I did speak to one of our prominent coaches yesterday, basketball coach Anthony Stewart, who has a lot of concerns. He spoke about his own kids and how they're doing their home schooling and a lot of that via online at the moment. But he says in their downtime they want to get on their screens and watch Netflix or play the PlayStation and things like that. So he's a bit worried about how this is going to look coming out of this, and hopefully kids are still going to be engaged in sport.
Absolutely. Good to talk to you, Brent. Thank you.
No worries, Darren. Thanks, mate.
Brent Costello, Wind News sports reporter, joining us on Tasmania Talks this morning.
So this is what a non-news golf club looks like.
Tasmania Talks.
Too bad it's on its way out.
It's May 12, International Nurses Day, marking the anniversary of the birth of Florence Nightingale, more important this year than ever.
I love that nursing is a mix of science and art.
I love that it's really active.
Personally, I love helping people.
A tribute to all our nurses. Apparently, it was on this day in 1968 that Reginald Dwight started using the name Elton John.
It didn't seem like being Reg Dwight. It had too many unhappy memories and sort of, I hated the word Reg anyway. I mean, it's just a horrible name.
And in 1975, Air Supply's Graham Russell met Russell Hitchcock on the opening day of rehearsals for the Australian production of Jesus Christ Superstar. Together they went on to have hits like this.
Wow, come on.
May 12th birthdays, one of the all-time most successful songwriters, Burt Bacharach, turns 92. What a list.
Burt Bacharach.
What's you, pussycat? Raindrops keep falling on my head. I'll never fall in love again. Close to you.
I think when the song is written and you know what you have, you go back and then the extra stuff gets kind of put into the mix.
Steve Winwood is 72. He had hits as the lead singer of the Spencer Davis Group before making a solo comeback in the 80s.
That was him, was it?
Gabriel Byrne celebrates his 70th. He was in Little Women, The Man in the Iron Mask, and fantastic in The Usual Suspects.
I'm not doing this for Fester. I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing this for me.
Emilio Estevez turns 58, one of the 80s Rat Pack, starring in The Breakfast Club and St Elmo's Fire, and then the Young Guns movies.
Yo, sir, I do admire you. I sure would like to touch the gun that's going to kill Billy Kim.
And Rami Malek is 39 today. He's the latest Bond villain in No Time to Die, but will long be remembered for his Academy Award-winning performance as Freddie Mercury in Bohemian Rhapsody.
Don't be so dramatic, darling. You're recording an album.
Finally, one of the greats of the silver screen was born on this day in 1907. Catherine Hepburn, the winner of four Academy Awards for Best Actress, died aged 96 in 2003.
There's so much thought and so little feeling, Professor.
I am.
Yes, you are, Mario.
Remembering Catherine Hepburn on May 12th. And celebrating this guy's birthday. Pretty good. Steve Winwood. This is Valerie on Tasmania Talks, 8 to midday.
And unfortunately, counterpoint a copyright strike. Bum bum bum. Or music strike, whatever it is. Dad, I suppose. May he and everyone in this cemetery rest in peace. Probably including whoever's in here to visit anyone, huh? So me as well. A lot of people died since Dad's died. My aunt being one of them. May they all rest in peace. All of the family is buried here. Cheers to those we've lost. Be it to COVID, be it to natural causes, be it to cancer, be it to anything that's fucked us all over. Everyone who's here, rest in peace. And anyone who's listening, may your family rest in peace as well, if they're dead. We all need a bit more respect in this life and a lot less finger pointing. Let's see. Nah, it's still going, of course.
here if it was with a child. Hey, look, there's a horsey looking. Hello, horsey. Hello, horsey, horsey. Aren't you a nice horsey? Just standing there in the rain. Queenstown. It never rains or pours.
I know you're listening to this radio ad, but I just wanted to say you're listening to this radio ad, and so are your customers. Because with nearly half of all listening taking place at home, radio's never been more relevant. If you need results from your advertising, visit radiolive.com.au.
Chemist Warehouse, great savings every day.
Let's give way to a person coming. Oh no, it's only an intersection. I-74F. See, look, can't even fucking stay on one side of the road. I may not be the best driver in the world, but at least I don't intentionally fucking go in front of anyone. Honestly. Some people just don't know how to fucking drive. What he did there was explain all the vehicles. There's a dickhead parked there. I'm always parked there. I don't care. I probably live there. It's not really much of a problem with me. But when you can't even be bothered giving way at a fucking intersection when you're meant to give way, you deserve everything you get. Oh wait, they deserve nothing. There's no cops around. If there is any cops around. I don't see a light on. Oh yeah, somebody's got a light on. Yay! Hey, someone's got a light on. Oh yes, just to let anyone know, I've seen and been around Queenstown for a while. I don't know, what, 35 years? So, been away a few times. But, the chances of anyone having their lights on during a cold, wet time like this is pretty much nil. Or, like this person coming up on me now, they like to speed. Wow! Amazing! Every single person's had their lights on, except that idiot who went around the corner. And we've got this dude. Oh, here we go. We've got this dude behind me going way too fucking fast. They just want to go faster than 50. What is wrong with people? There we go. I-52EN has no lights on. Nice vehicle here. FD0760 doesn't have his lights on. The person behind me is fucking trying to speed, obviously. And people wonder why I get pissed off. Well, the fact that I've been done for drink driving before, I've been done for this, that, and everything else. And when other people break the law, it gets real annoying. This dude in front of me, failure to have the lights on. Because we're supposed to have them on if it's wet, rainy, dusk, dawn, and stuff. EW4538. Hey, another one with their lights on. Good on ya. Bravo, bravo. And 3 seconds before you get to an intersection, you are meant to tell people that you're going to go this way. Indicate. I've just done.
just turn my lights on, not just on park. No one to the left, no one to the right. Of course, you're not supposed to say what you're doing because, hey, you're a professional driver. Been driving for X amount of years. Right. Suppose you have to say something for
an attendant in the bathroom or kitchen
camera.
And eat hot food at
wow.
Table. Not of your lack.
I'm not even going to bring up the fact that that truck, which you probably didn't see,
or seeking medical advice.
Totally broke the floor, parking on the wrong side of the road.
Some AFL clubs are furious over weak sanctions handed to the athletes for breaching training protocols. 16 players each receive a suspended one match.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Ben Hart was put
down love that.
For 6 weeks. An investigation found there was an inadvertent breach and not done to create a competitive advantage. English Premier League players have expressed concerns over a plan for the competition to resume in the middle of next month. Comes after a rising player tested positive for virus in the past few days. Sebastian Vettel will reportedly quit Ferrari at the end of the 2020 Formula One season, and Zoo's camp is keen to reschedule an all-Aussie show jet with or without a crowd. I'm Olivia Hicks, that's the latest in news and in sports.
But yes, that's what you get when people just get so lazy with their vehicle driving, they just forget to indicate, they forget to do this, forget to do that. Or they do it intentionally because they know we're in Queenstown, there's no cops. And I suppose I will leave this on. I'll just have to use can they indicate? Oh, yeah, he indicated. It's weird, you can't see on my angle. Yeah, I don't know. Leave it going, turn it off. Turn it off. Enjoy the quiet. Let me know if anyone bumps into the car. Okay, what do we got?
Oh yeah, still got more fucking crappy songs. I'll wait for this guy to go. That's assuming he wants to go. Yes. I saw you indicate there, mate. There you go. Sometimes you can't help it and your indicator goes off and all that with your funny wheel movements and that people do. And it's the intent more than what happened. So. Ooh. That's right. It has a memory, but it doesn't have a memory. And, check the mail.
Thank you.